Hey, you Thomas?
Yeah?
Well, I guess I'm your ride.
You're the driver?
You want to check my license?
No, that's okay. I just need to put something in your trunk.
All right. Long night, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Out partying or out studying?
I'm not a student here.
Oh, my bad. It's just that my usual clientele at this time of the night are either drunk frat bros or Asian students who will sleep in the library.
I guess it depends on the time of the season. Studying all night for most of the semester, party once exams are finished, then drink away their sorrows when the grades come out.
So, what are you doing around campus?
Nothing much, just business.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, I'm here on business too, at least at night I am. I'm a student by day and I drive around part-time so I could at least sustain myself.
Just full of stories tonight, aren't we?
Ah, sorry. My bad. I tend to ramble on sometimes. I'll stop.
No, that's okay. Sorry. Look, Landon, like you said, it's been a long night. And I have a train to catch in about 2 hours.
Yeah, no, I get it.
So what do you major in?
What?
No, wait. Let me guess. English.
Close. Creative writing. That's the good thing about this job, you know. I get to interview a lot of passengers. Gives me ideas for the next story.
I see.
Huh, that's a nice watch, by the way. Is that a Takoya?
Yep. Vintage. 1972.
Very old school. I dig it. See, my dad is still into collecting the most random vintage crap. You know, records, furnitures, typewriters, electronics, guns, you name it.
Feels like I'm in a museum every time I visit him.
Well, usually keep a picture of your girlfriend in your mirror. That's pretty old school, too.
Oh, no, that's Diane Conway. You know, the girl who went missing a few days ago?
See, she goes to the same college, but I've never seen her up close.
I see. So you keep her picture there, in case you happen to be the first person to recognize her. In case one day she just happens to materialize near campus, after missing for 12 days.
Yeah, well, when you say it like that, it does sound kind of stupid. I know, but it's never too late.
There was this girl in one of my classes who ran off with some rich oil tycoon in Thailand. Parents were searching for her for a week before they found out.
My point is, strange things can happen. One night, when I'm off making a long drive just like this one, I might just find her.
That's a waste.
What is?
It's a waste looking for her 12 days later, when you know what already happened. It's a waste of time. And fuel.
Well, call me an optimist then. But hey, even if I don't find her alive and well, there's a still chance that I might find a suspicious stranger wandering around campus carrying a large body-sized duffel bag. Looking all suspicious, you know.
Oh. I get it.
I'm just messing with you, man. It's just a joke.
No. Keep going.
That's alright, man. It was just a bad joke.
No. If I'm supposed to be listening to your rambling bullshit all night, I might as well be about something interesting.
So why don't you put that creative writing degree to the test? Thrill me.
What?
Have you ever heard of the Zone of Death? It's a park somewhere in Idaho. Spans over 50 square miles. Though apparently, it's actually an extension of Yellowstone Park in Cheyenne, Wyoming. Supposedly, this is the only place in America where it is legal to commit any crime, including murder. You see, the Sixth Amendment states that juries in a federal case must come from both district and state in which the crime was committed. So a murder committed in the zone of death would be ineligible for a constitutional trial. Assuming, of course, there's anyone around to even witness it. We're talking 50 square miles of open forest. And yet, not a single recorded murder in its entire history. I find this fascinating. It seems like when we are encouraged to give in to our darkest, most primal desires, we lose interest in them. Simply because there would be no more secrets left to hide.
And how does one know he is who he is? If he doesn't keep any secrets.
I'm just messing with you.
What?
I'm just messing with you.
I don't know what any of that even meant.
Dude, you almost gave me a heart attack.
What? I thought you'd like gang stories out of your passengers.
Yeah, but not when they're talking about their creepy murder fantasies.
Sorry, it's just that. It's just once you get me started, it's hard to. It's hard to stop, you know? I think I get the appeal of this job now.
So, Valley of Death, huh?
Zone of Death.
Alright.
It's a real place. Look it up.
I will. We'll definitely make an interesting story.
Just between the two of us. You really should do something about those claw marks in your trunk. The police might find remnants of her pretty pink nail polish. In fact, they might use her dogs to pick up a scent of dried blood, which lasts for weeks usually. You can probably get rid of that with hydrogen peroxide.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Although police dogs may not be trained to pick up in the peroxide, you might want to use baking soda instead. A much more common cleaning agent.
Smith & Wesson, Snubnose 38. Very old school. I dig it.
Landon, does your dad know you've been sneaking into his gun cabinet?
What do you want from me?
See, I'm trying to figure that out myself.
There's some things in the back that I'm supposed to get rid of. Ideally, I'm supposed to board that train, wait for about an hour until we pass over the nearest river, then throw that duffel bag out the window when no one's watching. But now I think I might have something more interesting in mind.
I want you to show me where you buried her.
Find a shovel in my bag. I want you to go to the exact spot where you buried her, and to dig a hole 6 feet deep. Or until you find her body, whichever comes first. For my silence, please. One more thing. Take out your wallet. Why do you really keep her picture there?
To remind me what I've done. There. You happy now? Now what?
Turn around. Go ahead. Look at her. Is that how she looked when you last saw her?
I don't know.
Look closer. Shine the light on her. Is that how she looked when you last saw her? Landon, it's okay. You can tell me anything. Because from out here.
No one can hear you!
I don't know. I wasn't thinking. I just got rid of her as soon as I could. There was nothing I could have done for her.
Notice the dirt under her fingernails. Or what's left of them anyways. Arms reaching out. In a state of rigor mortis. Eyes open. Mouth open. Looks like you didn't kill her after all. She died trying to claw her way out of the dirt. Imagine that. Waking up the pitch blackness, lungs filled with dirt. Can't see or breathe or hear anything. Could have at least had the courtesy of giving her a closed casket. Shit, man. Zaw could have been avoided if you just drove her to the hospital.
I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
What's that?
I didn't mean for any of this to happen. It was the one night I got drunk. The one night I lost control. The road was dark. So dark that when I hit her, it felt like it just ran over a speed bump. It wasn't until I saw the road turning red from all the blood in the headlights that I've realized what I've done. When I came back seeing her body all twisted up, her legs bending the wrong way, I didn't know what to do. I'd never seen a dead body before. Just standing there watching, it's like someone else was controlling my body. And I was praying it was all a bad dream, but it wasn't. I didn't even know what I was capable of. During the day, it feels normal sometimes. But at night, I can still see her body. I can feel her body weighing down the trunk of my car. And I can see the road turning red sometimes. Now what? You're gonna kill me, turn me in? Well, go ahead. I'm sorry, Diane, for everything that I've done to you, for everyone that I've hurt. And most of all, I'm sorry for this!
Hell of a story, Landon. Your best one yet. Yeah. There's still time.
To you, for everyone that I've hurt, and most of all, I'm sorry for this!
So, main station, right?
Yeah. Let's step on it too. I'm in a bit of a time crunch.
Long night, huh?
You have no fucking idea.